Thank you. Thank you very, very much. And thank you, all of our wonderful cast, past and present. And can I start off by talking about music tonight and thank our wonderful musical director and the biggest orchestra on Broadway who have played for the last 30 years. Thank you so much. Now, this is rather a special night for me for a number of reasons, and it gives me a chance to say thank you to somebody who, frankly, for the Phantom of the Opera, it wouldn't have happened without her. She was my muse. She was the person who was beside me when the whole show was being created. And it is a great, great joy for me tonight to be able to introduce you to my angel of music, Sarah Brightman.
Your manager commends you, sir.
I thought something was dodgy when I saw that stage management.
I wanted to come on first.
Oh, it's camera. Listen, several things. I've got several bones to pick with you.
What?
First, I never travel business class.
Well,
come all this way.
You've made enough money out of this to pay the extra, like everyone else does.
Well, like you don't.
Well, I buy my own plane.
You buy your own jet, I know.
I fly EasyJet.
Listen. Yes. Now, where's my piano?
What? No, you're
where's
not.
Where is
no,
the
you're
piano?
You're not to play again tonight.
Where is the
you're
piano,
not
Cameron?
To play again tonight.
You promised me a piano.
So I could do those new numbers
because we're rewriting the show.
You did the piano in London, and I haven't got over it yet. I was really, really upset. But before I want to say to you, look, 30 years.
Yep, okay.
Who'd have thought it? But I tell you, it was a bloody good idea, wasn't it? The show.
Well, it wasn't bad.
And thank God Sarah turned down Christine in that other version.
Oh, that other version.
And she had the
nous
to suggest to us
thank
that
God
Michael
that.
Crawford would be rather good in it.
Yes, it was her. It was indeed.
We've a lot to thank Sarah for.
We have a very, very, very great deal.
Yes.
But one of the things that I have to say, Cameron, and I hope you don't mind my saying this, is that
I
think the show is fine and it's pretty good technically and all that tonight, quite frankly, you know, we need to kind of get it going a little bit more. It doesn't really have a contemporary rock feel.
Well, it's your fault.
Well,
I remember once upon a time when we had really good director, apart from Hal Prince, before Hal Prince came and even improved it more, we had a wonderful video.
We had a wonderful video with serpents in it. Serpents directed by Ken Russell.
However, tonight,
I have decided to liven up the proceedings.
Yes.
And since you can't provide a piano for me,
what?
I have provided a proper rock group tonight.
Really?
So here, to sing and or to play for the first time live on stage, I have brought you tonight the kids from School of Rock.
Oh!
Our strange duet, my power over you, to glance behind. The phantom of the opera is there inside your mind. Those who have seen your face draw back in fear. I am the mask you wear.
It's me they hear.
My spirit and my voice hear one combined. The phantom of the opera is here inside my mind.
In all your fantasies, you always knew that man and mystery
were both in you.
And in this labyrinth, where night is blind, the phantom of the opera is there.
My mind.
Sing for me, my angel of music.
Is there the phantom of the opera?
Sing! Sing for me!
Well, gosh, we got a bit of tone into the proceedings.
Oh, I know. Class. You know, that's what you were like. You were classy once.
I always have been classy,
absolutely.
Cameron, and
good.
I intend to say that.
Yes,
way.
I know. And
so could you leave the stage?
Oh. Not yet.
No,
not yet.
Now, we have a lot of people we have to thank, and we have to start with some people who sadly are not here tonight.
Well, and, of course, the person who created the magic world of Phantom of the Opera, and who was with us actually even as the show was being written and when it was staged
down
absolutely. In Symington.
I mean, one of the most extraordinary things that can ever happen for any composer or any writer of a musical is when the design of the show completely, completely marries what one hoped. The music in every way was extraordinarily matched by the incredible Maria Bjornsson.
Cheers. And I know she's up there still sending her notes on everything. And she is truly, truly amazing.
She was a fantastic, fantastic thought. And an amazing, amazing designer in every single way. And she was indeed with us from the very, very word go. She even did the design when we tried it out at my little festival at Sydney.
Yes, and she crashed the chandelier on somebody's head, I seem to remember.
Yes, she did, actually. That's another about it. Happened to be the editor of the Sun newspaper, which was unfortunate, but never mind.
But also, her wonderful design is, of course, lit by the wonderful Andy Bridge, who has been with us also. And you'll see him in a minute.
Well, one of the saddest things tonight is that we don't have the great, fabulous Gillian Lynn with us. Gilly is... has unfortunately had a touch of pneumonia back in Britain, but we know she's recovering, and we send our very, very best wishes to dearest Jimmy.
There is no one like Jilly anywhere in the world. I've known her nearly all of my life, and her attention to detail and her imagination knows no bounds, and so we owe her an enormous debt.
And I must say thanks to Richard Stilgoe and Charlie Hart, our fabulous lyricist. Yes.
Amazing. We've been very lucky to have such a brilliant team.
We have, and it's one of those extraordinary things when I always think we are only just little cogs in that wheel of what it makes a great musical, and very rarely does it happen that every single element comes together, which I believe it did in this one.
Absolutely. And 30 years, not only here but around America, the amount of brilliant musicians and wonderful artists that have actually been involved.
Yes.
And all the people you don't see that make the scenery and pull our production teams and creative teams, they've been amazing.
I mean, it's an incredible achievement. I was just thinking tonight, I mean, it's a black box but full of wonderful, wonderful bits of scenery. But it's a real, really extraordinary thing that the stage crew do every night. So thank you to them.
And we should also thank the other vital component, which is the audience, who have loved the show since the very, very first preview in London. So we thank you, and we thank you for allowing him to even go business class. And me first.
Premium economy, I think it was.
Will you really accept that now?
Thank you, Hal. Now,
there's one other person.
There is
who
one.
Who is the only... He's the master. The master producer... The master director, one of the greatest men of show business and the musical theatre, the one and only Hal Prince.
I come bearing some statistics. I love to do this every 5 years. It took and takes every night 125 people to entertain you in the house. People from front of house, backstage, stage crew, dressers, and, of course, musicians and cast. 125, that's a lot. Over 1,000 members of Actors Equity have been employed by this show here. In addition, employment has extended to 6,500 people, including vendors, artisans, and front of house and all the rest. But it's a... Actually, it's affected other businesses, restaurants, coffee shops, and God help us, parking lot owners. Phantom has played 174 cities in 37 countries. To an audience of over 140 million people. my friends here have mentioned the amazing collection of collaborators we had through the rehearsal period, through the previews, and for the length, the very extended length of this show. One of the most important, was our lighting designer, and happily, he is here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Andy Britt. And now, I want to introduce you to the class of 1988.
So, it's our birthday, so it's your turn now, and we're going to sing Happy Birthday, not just for us, but also for the fabulous Hal Prince, who is 90 years of age next week!